Good morning, students. Today I will start with the first lesson of civics, that is power sharing. So in this particular chapter, basically it has been explained that any organization, be it a country, be it a nation, be it a simple organization, must believe in power sharing as a mechanism if they want their organization or their country or their nation to function successfully. Like right now, if we take the example of our country, that is India, so you would see that if this is the structure of our country, at the topmost level we have central government, at the middle level we have state government, and at the bottom most level we have Panchayati Raj institutions or urban local bodies, which are also called as local self-government. Now to run the country, the power is divided between these two. That is, state government has its own power and central government has its own power. Ek Supreme Court hai, jo puri country ke liye hai, aur har state ke liye एक हाई कोर्ट है. आई होप यू ऑल नो दैट. सो इफ वी टॉक अबाउट आवर स्टेट झारखंड, द हाई कोर्ट ऑफ झारखंड इज इन रांची. सो व्हाई डू वी हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पावर मैकेनिज्म? सो दैट ऑल द लेवल दे फील पार्टिसिपेटेड, एंड व्हेन यू फील पार्टिसिपेटेड यू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट मोर, यू आर कंपैरेटिवली प्रोडक्टिव बिकॉज यू फील दैट यू आर वन ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ अ सिस्टम. So the chapter basically starts that in a democracy, all power should not rest with any one organ of the government. So if all power is concentrated in one organ of the government, the other organs or the other level, they will not feel participated and their voice will not be heard. So what do we need is an intelligent sharing of power among legislature, executive and judiciary. So if we talk about the organs of government, legislature, executive and judiciary. Legislature make laws, executive execute laws, and judiciary interpret laws and looks into any dispute between legislature and executive. So that is how a power sharing mechanism is maintained. And when we talk about levels of government, then the same thing is there. Central government, state government and the local self-government. So again the power is divided. Central government takes decision on very important subjects. Atomic energy, defense, external affairs, communication. On these subjects only central government can take decision because these are very sensitive topics for the nation. Then when we come to state government, law and order, police, land, agriculture, on all these things, state government can take decision on its own. For every little thing, state government does not need to take permission from central government. So this is how the power sharing mechanism works. So there are certain countries where this mechanism is not applied, and those countries, they may be or they may term or call themselves a democratic country, but they are not actually maintaining the essence of the democracy. One of a very important aspect of a democratic country is power sharing. So your chapter starts with case studies of two countries, Belgium and Sri Lanka. So we'll start with Belgium. Belgium is a small country in Europe, smaller in area than the state of Haryana. It has borders with France, Netherlands, Germany and Luxembourg. It has a population of little over 1 crore, about half the population of Haryana. So Belgium is a very small country. The population of Haryana is equal to the population of Belgium. At times CBSE has asked this question, that Belgium shares borders with which countries? So you need to remember it. Certain facts cannot be just left out, assuming that this won't be a part of the question. The ethnic composition of this small country is very complex. What do we mean by ethnic? a social division based on shared culture. So people may belong to the same group, but they have dissimilarities in what they believe. They don't need to have from the same religion. दिखेंगे एक जैसे, कपड़े भी एक ही जैसे पहनते होंगे, कल्चर भी शायद सेम होगा, लेकिन कुछ बिलीफ उनके डिफरेंस होते हैं. हो सकता है उनका रिलीजियन डिफरेंस हो. नाउ when we आर इन इंडिया, यू विल सी सम ऑफ द ट्राइबल पीपल, दे आर इंडियन, दे लुक लाइक अस, ऑफकोर्स दे वेयर क्लोथ्स लाइक अस, बट देयर रिलीजियस बिलीफ इज डिफरेंट. दे डोंट बिलीव इन स्क्रिप्चर्स, दे बिलीव इन लिविंग गॉड्स. सो दैट इज द एथनिक कॉम्पोजिशन. सो द एथनिक कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ दिस कंट्री is very complex. Of the total population, 59% lives in Flemish region and speak Dutch, and 40% live in Wallonia region and speak French. So there's a linguistic diversity over here that is based on language. So 59% of the population speaks Dutch, and 40% of the people they speak French, and remaining 1% they speak German. The capital city of the Belgium, that is Brussels, 80% speak French and 20% speak Dutch. Now a very complex situation. When we see in the capital city, which is always the seat of the central government, like if you see India, the capital is Delhi and the seat of the central government is Delhi. That's why we say Delhi ki sarkar, right? तो कैपिटल सिटी जहां पे सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का सीच होता है, वहां पे 80% फ्रेंच स्पीकर्स हैं और 20% डच स्पीकर्स हैं. बट व्हेन वी सी नेशन वाइड, डच स्पीकर्स 59% एंड फ्रेंच स्पीकर्स 40%. दैट इज रिलेटिवली इट इज लेस. द माइनॉरिटी फ्रेंच स्पीकिंग कम्युनिटी वॉज रिलेटिवली लिच एंड पावरफुल. नाउ वाई माइनॉरिटी फ्रेंच? बिकॉज हियर यू हैव सीन दैट 40% दे स्पीक फ्रेंच. So minority means less in number and majority means more in number. This was rejected by the Dutch speaking community, who got the benefit of economic development and education much later. So of course, because the diversity is very complex in nature, this led to tensions between the Dutch speaking and French speaking communities. Now the tension started increasing. Brussels mein ek special problem tha. Ab wahan Dutch majority mein the, लेकिन कैपिटल में जब देखते तो माइनॉरिटी में हो जाते. तो नेशन वाइज अगर आप देखिए, डच क्या है? मेजॉरिटी में है, लेकिन कैपिटल सिटी में जाइए तो वो माइनॉरिटी में हो जाते थे. नाउ अ वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स सिचुएशन. जो नेशन वाइज मेजॉरिटी में है वो कैपिटल में माइनॉरिटी हो गया, जो नेशन वाइज माइनॉरिटी में है वो कैपिटल में मेजॉरिटी में हो गया. वाई कैपिटल इज एन इश्यू? बिकॉज द सीट ऑफ द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज ऑलवेज द कैपिटल ऑफ द कंट्री. लेट्स कम टू द अदर केस स्टडी, श्रीलंका, विच इज एन आइलैंड नेशन. इट इज अबाउट 2 करोड़ पीपल, अबाउट द सेम एज इन हरियाणा. श्रीलंका का भी पॉपुलेशन बहुत डाइवर्स है. वहां पे सिन्हाला स्पीकर्स है, जो वहां की लैंग्वेज है, दैट इज 74%. And Tamil speakers 18%. And among Tamils also, there are 2 subdivisions. Tamil natives of the country, जो वहीं के रहने वाले हैं, तो native मतलब local, that are Sri Lankan Tamils. And the rest are the people who have migrated or come from India as plantation workers, colonial period के time पे, जिन्हें कहा जाता है Indian Tamils. So if you see, the population is majorly Sinhala speakers and Tamil speakers. Out of which Tamil is again segregated. One are the native Tamilians and the other ones are Indian Tamilians. Okay? Now, most of the Sinhala speaking people are Buddhist, while most of the Tamils are Hindus or Muslims. Belgium handled this complex diversity in a very beautiful manner. Sri Lanka handled this diversity in a very disastrous manner. So Belgium came out to be functioning very smoothly, and there was a civil riot in Belgium which led to communal clash as well, and lots of loss of energy, resource, property. That country had to face immense disaster. So basically, why these case studies? That is, if the government of the country is not able to handle the conflict among the people, it leads to chaos. But if the government of the country is able to handle the conflict, that leads to harmony. And harmony is the essence of democracy. When we stay together, when there is solidarity, when there is fraternity, then only a democratic country can function smoothly. So let's see then what happened in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka emerged as an independent country in 1948. The leaders of the Sinhala community, they wanted to secure dominance over government by virtue of their majority. Because you had seen Sinhala speakers were more in number. As a result, the democratically elected government adopted a series of majoritarian. Majoritarianism is a philosophy where major rules are framed keeping in mind the people who belong to majority. A belief that the majority community should be able to rule a country. That is, the rights of the minorities are completely neglected. Only the majorities are taken into consideration. A democratically elected government cannot adopt majoritarianism. Because you were elected by both majority as well as minority. What about this section? Which was also a part of electing the government. They went to the extreme. In 1956, an act was passed to recognize Sinhala as the only official language. That is, you are giving complete power to the people who are Sinhalis, who are speakers of Sinhala. And you are completely negating the fact that there are other language speakers as well in your country. So you are completely disregarding Tamil. You are not trying to establish harmony. In fact, you are trying to disrupt and create a problem in the harmony of the country. Not only this, the government followed preferential policies that followed Sinhala applicants for university positions and government jobs. All the important government jobs and specialized university positions were reserved for the people who belong to the section of Sinhala speakers. What about the people who were Sri Lankans, but only because they were not Sinhala speakers, they were sidelined. The conflict had to increase. Not only this, a new constitution was made that stipulated that the state shall protect and foster, that is promote Buddhism. In India, if you see, nothing of this sort happens. Government does not function on the basis of religion. Religion creates problem. You cannot protect and foster any particular religion at the cost of another. And the same thing was happening here. All these government measures kept building hatred, discontentment in the heart of the people who were not Sinhala speakers. They felt that the constitution and government politics denied them the equal rights. They were discriminated in getting jobs. So as a minority, their interests were being completely negated, completely sidelined. And the relation between Sinhala speakers and Tamil speakers gradually started leading to discontentment and hatred. The Sri Lankan Tamils launched struggles for the recognition of Tamil as official language. They wanted regional freedom. They wanted equality of opportunity in job. But their demands was not taken care of. Then several political organizations came to the forefront who started demanding an independent Tamil Elan, that is state, in northern and eastern parts of Sri Lanka. The government did not adhere to the demands. Finally, what happened? It turned into a widespread conflict and it turned into a civil war. Civil war means external aggression nahi hai. Bahar se kisi ne aap pe attack nahi kiya. Aap aapas mein itni buri tarah se lad gaye hain. Civilians aapas mein lad gaye hain, that is civil war. As a result, thousands of people were killed. Of course, jab ladai hoti hai to dono hi side ke log marte hain. Many families were forced to leave the country. Complete terrible setback. Social, cultural, economical loss of the country. Why? Because the government did not believe in power share. So that's all for today. In the next video and in the online class as well, we will discuss the case study of Belgium and how power sharing leads to development of the country.